You know, the thing with Tekken in general is that the last time they tried any real meaningful innovation with the series was Tekken 4. And that's coming on 20 years ago now. Like, more than. That's 2001. So yeah, that's Tekken 5 was sort of like a reaction to Tekken 4 and the bold risks it took. And it's a better game. Absolutely. Tekken 5 is much more competitive and much more fun, but it also sort of threw out the baby with the bathwater, I feel, in terms of the ideas that it presented. And ever since Tekken 5, we haven't really gotten any meaningful new, meaningful innovation in Tekken. We're still really playing Tekken 5. Tekken 7 is Tekken 5.7. That's the joke, right?
So,
I would love for them, for Tekken 8, for them to really kind of strike new ground, like look at what is the defining core appeal of Tekken and focus on that. Because I feel like Tekken's sort of become a bit watered down, especially with, you know, there's all this complaint of like bloat and power creep, and it all points at the same problem, which is just a lack of general vision and direction with where they want to go with the game. They just keep adding and adding and adding, but it's like they need to ask themselves, what is the core appeal of Tekken? What got people hooked on it in the first place? I mean, when you say Tekken, still to most people's minds, it's Tekken 3. And that, like, close second is Tekken 7, just because it's been such success. And, but, you know, now is the day of social media, now is the day of streamers, now is, you know, the day of esports. But for its time, Tekken 3 was an absolute phenomenon. So, I think the Tekken team needs to kind of reassess, like, what made Tekken 3 strike such a chord with not just gamers, but just, like, general people, right? Tekken 3 sold PlayStation. It was like a cultural kind of, cultural significance. Yeah, really. It really did.
Yeah.
So
I noticed that when the Tekken 2 came out, and we've talked about this a lot, Kai and I, about how Tekken 2 very much resembled the 80s. It had a lot of 80s vibes, a lot of 80s aesthetics. It had some.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah, it had a little bit of everything. We could talk about Tekken 2. Tekken 2 is one of my favorites. We could just talk about that for a whole hour. Oh, yeah. But then when they moved on from Tekken 2 and they went to Tekken 3, they kind of abandoned that 80s aesthetic and adopted what would be considered a more 90s approach. You know, Jin was the more bad boy. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And it was just phenomenal. Each of the games, particularly 2 and 3, and even 4 in a major way, they all took a strong stance, I felt, on relating to that era.
Definitely.
And I think because we're in a, you know, a post-COVID, you know, post-internet era, that it's kind of hard to identify what is this era. You know, 80s is so easy. You know 80s when you see it. You know 90s when you see it. You even kind of know Y2K when you see it. But what is 2017? What's 2018 look like? And I think that takes a lot of bandwidth and a lot of inspiration and a lot of manpower to develop an aesthetic for the modern time. You know what I mean?
Absolutely. Yeah. I mean, maybe we'll look back on this in 10 years and be like,
no idea what the 20s
aesthetic was. Right? Hindsight is 2021, right? So we'll never know, but you're right. I mean, if there's one thing that could be pointed at Tekken 7, which I guess could lie at a greater sort of cultural issue, is that does 2021 have an aesthetic to it, right? Or is it just a hodgepodge of previous aesthetics? It's hard to know because we're living in it right now.
Hey, thanks for watching, and to Arcade Press for taking the time to interview me. You can check out their newsletter and podcasts in the description below.